Get ready to match the stars. Robert Vaughn, Rhett Sommers, McLean Stevenson, Nancy Dussault, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded big money match game 73. And now here's the host of match game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you very much. How kind of you to come. Thank you for being with us, wherever you are. And since somebody forgot to strike the rehearsal stool, I'll just get the heck out of the way. And it's all done. You see, that's the way you do it. That's it for the stool. I'd like to welcome the new kids on the block here. We all enjoy watching the Protectors, and Robert Vaughn is a fellow we see on that all the time. Nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
Yeah. He's good at fun and games.
Oh, yeah.
And let's see, everyone else on the show has been here before. Is this your first time?
My first time.
You may kiss me on the lips.
I'm going to. We'll be sorry.
Okay, see?
It's not catching. It's all right.
Hey, listen, let's say hello to our two players here, Connie Atwood and Antoinette Osborne. Antoinette's a current champion. She's got $950 to her credit. She's won two games, and she's very happy about that, aren't you?
Yes.
And she's being challenged by Connie Atwood. We started this game last time out, and Connie is ahead at the moment, 2-0. We finished round one, and we're going to have a go at round two. Right, ladies?
Right.
Okay, we'll do that right after we have a go at these messages for you. Now we're ready to have a go at round two, ladies. I'll push the button here and reveal the two questions. We ask the challenger to make the selection. So, Connie, if you would, please.
B.
She wants B. Last time out, you matched these two people here, Richard and Betty.
I took them, Carrie. I was...
Anyway, you will, Richard and Betty, you'll lay out, and this is for the rest of you, okay?
That's enough, then.
No, what I mean is just do not write. That's all. Yeah. That's all.
All right.
Okay.
Sure you don't want us to lay out?
No. Just do not participate. Okay. One spy said to another, "Beware of Lola. One of her blanks is really a camera." You must respond in the reasonable future there. One spy said to another, "Beware of Lola, one of her blanks is really a camera."
I've never been so glad to lay out.
Okay, Nancy is ready. And Connie is thinking of her answer while we're waiting for the others. Okay, Connie, we're all set. So give us your response. "Beware of Lola, one of her blanks is really a camera." How do you fill in that blank?
Oh, gee, one of her boobs.
Okay.
Happy Monday.
All right. Okay. What do I do now? Oh, I come over here, right?
Yeah, I don't know.
She said...
Yes, I know what she said.
Yeah, we heard her. What do you say?
If you slur this word, possibly we can get one of her beads maybe the camera.
Beads. She said one of her beads is the camera. Yeah. Okay, that does not match. Brett, what do you say?
Whatever it was she said, I thought of it first and I cast it out. I said ears.
One of her ears, yes.
What about that?
Now, America, this could be a biggie. This could take you right off the air altogether.
Now, wait a minute. Shall I preview it first?
No.
It's my show.
No, but get the guys with the glasses and the suits together for a meeting because there may be trouble.
All right.
Okay, I said one of her pecs. Well, that gets no laughs. A peck is a lady's...
That's a match.
Okay.
We all assume that you're referring to the pectoral muscles.
That's correct. Or boob, as your case may be.
Yes, that's right. Oh, yeah.
I love you, your bushel, and your pecs.
Nancy, would
what is
you
it?
Like to restore a little sanity to this whole proceeding?
A little dignity. One of her rings.
One of her rings.
Connie, you look so nice, too.
So, Connie, that's three for you. And now let's see what we've got for you. Antoinette, since this is the final round, you must match three celebrities to stay in the running. Four, however, will win the game. Everyone participates, since she didn't match anyone last time out. Dr. Pasteur shouted, Pierre, Pierre, come quickly to the microscope. These two germs are blanking. He says, Pierre, come quickly. Look at these two germs. They are blanking.
I want you to go to your room and
okay,
stay
I'm going
there.
To my room.
I'm pretty sure she isn't going to say that.
Support.
All right. Betty's the first one finished, and
yes,
she's thinking
yes.
how she's going to phrase the whole
yes,
thing
true.
When it comes to her. Then. All right. Did you finish, sir?
Yes, oh, I'm sorry.
You've got to put that in. See, when you do that, it lights up, and then I know you're finished there.
I usually help.
Everybody's ready. So, Antoinette. Dr. Pasteur shouted, Pierre, come quickly to the microscope. These two germs are...
Making love.
Are making love. Okay, that's what she said. Now,
never had a germ get a hand.
I'm first.
You are first, Robert.
It's the same thing, you see. They are germinating.
Germinating.
Yes,
of course. Okay. Good, that is a match.
Good.
And very cleverly put,
yes,
if I may
good.
Say so,
I'm
sir.
Clever.
Yes, yeah, I would like to say
put?
So, too.
Well, Fred, what do you say?
I said mating.
Mating, yeah. He gets right to the point. How about you, McLean?
Well, I'll tell you what I said. Why don't we just forget the whole thing and all go over to my place? I said kissing.
Kissing. No. No, Max. All right, you need one more to stay in the game, Antoinette. You got three possibilities here. Here's a possibility. Nancy, what do you say?
Oh, well, McLean's so dumb. I said kissing.
Kissing. So you got two kissers there. You need one more, one of those other answers. What do you say there, Richard? There,
I happen to know them very well. They were breeding.
Breeding. That ties the score. All right, Betty White, it's up to you. If she matches you, she wins the game.
Multiplying.
Multiplying wins the game. Congratulations. Okay, come on down. All right. You've been on that spot before. Congratulations. Another $100 for you. And to Connie, our thanks for being with us on Match Game 73. A gift for you backstage, Connie.
Enjoyed it.
Connie Atwood, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. All right. All set?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Happy.
Are you happy? Good. You're up to $1,050 now. You're going to have a chance at over $5,000. We polled a recent studio audience, Antoinette. We got their best response to this. Ham blank. The answer they gave most often... Would you bring it up a little further, fellas? You brought it down too low. Just take it up. I'll tell you where. Up, up, up a little. That's it. A little more. A little more. Up a little higher. That's it. Sit up. Up a little more now. There you go, fellas. All right, cut it right there. That's fine. All right. And no, don't turn it on until I tell you to, okay?
Hey, mister, you're silent.
You do windows?
Yes, I do windows. Only on Thursdays, though. So, where was I? Oh, yes. Now, you know, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, choose your celebrities one at a time for a little help.
Richard Dawson.
Oh, well, one of the stars of the new Perry Mason show, Hamburger.
Hamburger. Okay. That's Brett Summers' show there. Hamburger, okay.
Oh, I'll withdraw the question.
So you got Hamburger. What else do you need there?
Brett.
I said ham sandwich.
Ham sandwich. Audience likes that. One more.
Betty.
Betty White, ham blank.
Ah, Hamlet. Ham and eggs.
Ham and eggs, she said.
Well done.
you've got
over easy.
Hamburger, ham sandwich, and ham and eggs, Antoinette. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Hamburger.
Hamburger. That's what you want to do. Okay. That's what we're looking for, hamburger. Let's begin by revealing the $100 response. Ham sandwich is up there, the one that Brett gave you. Okay, still looking for hamburger. Here is the $250 response. Hamburger! Congratulations. That's the one Richard gave you. All right, before we go on now with the rest of this, let's see the $500 response. Ham and eggs. Betty White gave you that one. All right, you went with hamburger. That means you've won $250, and that also means you are now playing for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. To collect the amount, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It will have to be an exact match, as you know, and please choose a celebrity now.
Richard.
Richard, you get ready to write, and Antoinette's going to face me, and I will get the $2,500 question. This is it. Pin blank. That's P-I-N blank. Okay, Richard is ready. Now, Antoinette, you fill in that blank. Pin.
Needle.
Pin and needle, is that?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
Well, I feel like a boob. I put pinhead.
Pinhead. Okay, so you're both on two different tracks there. Well, you've increased your earnings, Antoinette. You're up to $1,300. You're going to meet another player right after we pass along these messages. We're ready to start a new game, and to do that, we've got to say hello to a new player. So let's welcome here Charlie Boldu. Hi, Charlie.
Thank you.
Boldu.
Boldu.
The accent, both syllables are equally accented?
Equally.
What kind of name is that, Charlie?
French. French-Canadian.
Boldu.
Right.
French. What else do you want to tell us about yourself?
I'm single and the father of two children.
And a few, those of you.
And I'm retired.
You retired?
I'm retired.
You fathered two children and you're retired, eh?
Yeah.
What have you retired from, fathering children or business?
Whichever comes easiest.
I'll withdraw the question.
Yeah. What do you do for a living, Charlie?
I'm in advertising.
You're in advertising?
Yes.
All right, good luck here. You know how this goes?
Yes, sir.
You and this lady will be answering questions, trying to match the six celebrities. The one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner. And then we'll have a go at over $5,000 in the super match. Here we go. The challenger is asked to make a selection. The reason we leave it up to you is because some of our contestants find some of these questions more difficult than others. What do you say, Charlie?
B.
B is what he says. Charlie Boldu says B. Here it is. Because of the meat shortage, Archie Bunker no longer calls his son-in-law Meathead. Now he calls him Blankhead. Because of the meat shortage. Archie Bunker no longer called. No, you rascal, madam. And you look like such a sweet middle-aged lady there, too. No longer calls his son-in-law Meathead. Now he calls him Blankhead. Ready down here? Brett, you ready? Okay, let's get a response from Charlie. Archie Bunker no longer calls his son-in-law Meathead. Now he calls him...
Pighead.
Pighead, he says. By Jove, he said Pighead. Okay, pig is the answer. You say no, audience?
No! Yeah, let's have an audience. It's better with an audience.
Yeah. Well, let's see what the celebrities say. What do you say, celebrity?
Pinhead.
Pinhead.
That's, no meat there.
Okay. Instead of Meathead. Brett?
Well, pork is meat. Isn't pork meat? And isn't meat pork?
Right.
Right. I said fish head, but I didn't know how to spell.
Fish head. Was that your answer, audience? Fish head? Yeah. That's not a bad answer, McLean.
Unbelievable that that gets a laugh or any response at all. Yes. However.
Listen. Who are you yourself together and stay in your chair.
So serious about the game.
Did you see the laser? You have to double.
Don't hit him there again.
Hey, pick the other.
He's so cheap.
I gotta wear this coat Friday. Okay.
All right.
Ready?
I'm walking through the camera shot here. Hello there. Okay, I walk through the camera shot. Now, McLean, pig is the answer that we got from Charlie.
I'm sorry. I
knucklehead.
Didn't even say it. Knuckle.
Knucklehead.
He's upside down.
Oh, well, possibly it's right. Luckily.
Knucklehead, he said. What do you say, madam? Mademoiselle.
Mademoiselle?
Yes.
I said egghead.
Egghead.
That makes sense.
Very good answer.
Very yeah.
Did you like
nice.
That?
Certainly. Nice work. What do you say, sir?
Well, I said veg.
Head. Veg head.
So
Archie Bunker would say that, wouldn't he?
You know what I'm doing
Charlie
now?
Charlie didn't say it.
You know what I'm doing now?
What?
I'm cleaning my bathroom bowl.
Are we allowed to change seats?
No. Betty White.
Would you buy Pinhead?
Pinhead. Close to pig, but I mean...
thanks
so Charlie didn't do well with that at all. Let's see how Antoinette does with this. Everyone participates once again. Harry said... Harry said... The trouble with being on a chain gang is that it's so hard to blink with a ball on. That's the only time I'm going to read it, because it's a very dangerous question.
Oh, read it one more time.
No, you heard the whole thing. All right, this is the last chance. Harry said, Antoinette, are you listening? Harry said, the trouble with being on a chain gang is that it's so hard to blank with a ball on.
With a ball?
A ball. You know, in a chain gang, they wear chains and a big iron ball. Okay, everybody's ready?
I can only lead to trouble.
And we need an answer from Antoinette. Is it so hard to... what's going on?
I'll be with you in a moment.
She can't even spell Dussault. Don't be silly.
It's not easy.
What is your response to this, Antoinette? It's so hard to...
Walk
with a ball on. Okay. Robert Vaughn, what do you say?
Nothing funny, but correct.
Walk. One for Antoinette. Brett.
I never had any trouble walking, but fooling around was really tough.
Yeah. Okay, McLean. Walk.
He's so proud.
Attaboy. Don't hit him. What do you say?
I said play or whatever.
Play or whatever.
I thought that would cover
Well, that's
everything.
The same answer that Brett gave, in effect, there.
We Good. Win.
Okay. What do you say, Richard?
Having been on the chain gang,
yes.
It is very difficult to attend to nature's call.
Everybody has to leave the room.
Yes. We got it. Just get it in that center. All right, walk is the answer she's looking for. What do you got?
You have to learn to walk before you can run.
Run is tough. All right, so at the end of round one, the champion is ahead 2-0. Round two is coming up right after we pass along this message for you. Now we're ready to have a go at round two. If you are too, I push the button and nothing happens. Oh, there it is. So, Charlie, would you make a decision here?
Gotta go with B.
B is what Charlie wants. No one matched him last time, or he matched no one last time, so this is it. Everyone plays. Bertha's blank smells like a brewery. Bertha's blank smells like a brewery.
Keeps me off the street, Gene. That's the way I look at it.
Okay. All right, Charlie. Bertha's...
breath.
Her breath.
Her breath
smells like a brewery. That's what he says. Robert Vaughn, what do you say?
That's what I say.
He said that too, so there's one for you, Charlie. Brett?
Me three.
Brett says breath. Oh, he's rolling now. McLean. There it is. Another one. Wow.
Fancy.
No, I was looking to see if your light was on or not.
Oh, yes.
What is your light on?
You bet you're a booze.
Breath! There's another one.
You can take me
And
out.
You, sir.
I was terrified. I thought you
had a lisp there for a moment. Breath.
Breath is what he said. Fantastic. Now let's see if Betty White makes it a perfect sextet.
Oh, thank you, Gene. Just reminiscing. It's Brett.
Brett, yes. So he's got them all. And you know what you have to do? We don't have time to do it now, but first we've got this commercial for you, and then we'll tell you what's going to happen. Now, we really don't have time to finish this final round. And you know what you have to do. You've got to match four celebrities just to achieve a tie and stay in the running. We're going to have to do that next time. And I'm sure you're going to show up next time.
Yes.
I'm sure you're going to show up next time. Because you all have a lot of fun today, right?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Right on.
What are you doing there?
I got it. My gums are killing me.
Your gums are killing you.
You never know.
See, there'll be more of all of this, whatever you call this. Next time, I hope you'll join us. Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are for Montgomery Ward's Christmas catalog, the charm and beauty of a Tiffany table lamp. It's yesterday's lighting today, a fine item from the Montgomery Ward catalog. And glamorous Eternal Lash eyelashes. You put them on once easily, they stay on alluringly, work, shower, sleep, and stay beautiful, Eternal Lash. And a supply of delicious fill and eat Ready Crust. Your dessert will seem like it came from the pastry chef. Ready Crust, a special treat. And Snowy Bleach, the exclusive blended formula with extra washes per box, safe for whites and colors. Snowy Bleach. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. We'll be right back.